So now that I know that this is mixed up convention works, okay. By the way, you can zoom in if you want, but for demo, I'm gonna keep it large. So let's do a demo here. Let's go ahead and do something nasty. We always love to do nasty things, right?
Shut down the server.
Shut down the server. You're so bad. Okay. Now remember that we are actually monitoring the AdventureWorks database, right? So I'm on the office SharePoint server now, and let's make this database offline. Now there obviously can be a lot of things that happens to the database. I want to show you a quick one and take this database offline. So as you can see now, this particular database is offline. Okay. So what happens here is that there is an agent running on every one of these servers. And the agent is running to monitor anything that happens on that particular server. So it is not monitoring off the network bandwidth. So some of the customers always had that concern, right? How does it impact my network bandwidth? So the network will not be utilized until there's something happen and I send that little 1 kilobyte message up to the operations manager server. Okay, let's see whether he has picked it up yet. Okay. It takes a, depending on the interval, right, you can set it to be more frequent. The default here is that it will pull every 2 minutes. Okay. So you can set it more frequent if you want. Now while waiting for this error to come up, is there any questions? You have for now?
So you mentioned the management flag.
Mm-hmm.
And the management flag used in subsequent situation.
Okay, question here is can these management flags be also used by another product called System Center Essentials? The answer is yes. Because in system, okay, just let me just do a quick one. System Center Essentials is a product targeted for the mid-market companies that has operations manager in its entirety, together with some patch management and inventory components. That's what Essentials is. So because it's full operations manager, the management packs can be used. So it works both ways. Right? Okay, so can you see that my AdventureWorks is down? Right? Now why is AdventureWorks down? Right? You can see that because of the AdventureWorks database. Okay, so imagine that if I had set it up to SMS me or alert me, right, and I'm carrying a laptop or something which I can access my emails, right? So what I can see that because the database is down, it is affecting my overall AdventureWorks application. What do you do, right? So you can at this moment do a right click and open your alert view. Right? You can actually see the actual alert and say, okay, the database is actually offline. Right? You can actually, oops. You can actually go in here and see the Health Explorer to see the root cause. And you can see the summary again, the knowledge base, what is the possible causes. And if you can see, right at the bottom here, there's a resolution. So the nice thing is some of these resolutions is actually a hyperlink to a particular task, right? So this is what I call a silver bullet, right? So all I have to do to bring it up, I just click on that link, is to set the database online. I click on run. And what it goes out to do, it goes out to start that or bring that database online. Okay, give it a couple of seconds. Okay, so what it actually does and gives you an output, it actually executes a query. So this is what the task is doing in the background. It executes a query to alter the database state to online. All right, and you can see. that if I go back to the SharePoint server and I do a refresh, the database is back online. So the nice thing here is that I didn't need to go to my SharePoint server. Right? I could do everything from the console. And guess what? If you sign up to email, when you get the email description, that link will also be in the email. So from the email itself, I could have clicked the link and it would have done the job. Right? Let's go back to the Operations Manager server. Let's do a refresh. And it's back online. The database is back online. Right? And in a couple of seconds, this will be refreshed to be back online as well. Okay? So this is what we call multi end-to-end. So it's not just limited here. Right? Remember we talked about network devices? So we can even put network device components in there. Right? So everything, even on a client. Right? So you want to monitor from the client perspective as well. So everything that in that particular flow. Okay? Any questions so far? On this? Yes.
Okay, for a new beginner, operation manager, how long will it take for to use?
Okay. Question here is that for a beginner operations manager, how long will it take to use? From what you have seen so far, how long do you think it will take?
Depends also. Yeah. 5 days.
4 to 5 days? Is that a long time?
Depends also. No, not long.
Not really, right? 1 week is not really a long time, right? Okay, the nice thing about I like about operations manager is, you know, well, generally in Microsoft products there's a lot of wizards, right? Yeah. So when you configure things like that, so you notice, right? I set up the operations manager server. The next thing I do is import management packs. The minute I import the management packs, like what I showed you, right? It's already start monitoring. Then you have the alerts. When the alert comes in, what do you do? Like what I did just now, right click Health Explorer. Take a look at what the alert is. If I don't know what it is, what do? I see the knowledge base. In the knowledge base, I'll be very frank with you, not all the time the knowledge base is useful, but at least it's a starting point. I can take that and I can do a better search. And I start recovering. But at least you know, the minute you have this, is that you at least you have an eye now on your servers, right? Rather than none at all, right? So that's a distributed application I want to show you. Am I okay for time, Patrick? Yeah?
Another 5 minutes.
Another? Yes.
Is this only installed on
one
server?
Okay, question here is this only installed on one server? Question is, it depends on how many servers you want. So Operations Manager has a SQL, it needs database. It has the management server. And it has another component called root management server. The difference is that, well, database is database, okay? It also needs a data warehouse if you want to store historical data, okay? Root management server contains the SDK service. When it comes to the management packs, the consoles, that is handled by the SDK service, okay? The root management server is also a management server. So management servers are normally the guy that actually takes all the